that praise him. I've been working on something else. Had some really good points. But he dropped it in my spirit. And when he dropped it in my spirit, I went to do a research. He said, y'all access have been granted in the spirit. Give them some instruction first. Tell them that everything they've been praying for. I just want to believe her. Everything that you've been promised. Everything that you believe for, everything that been, and then he told me something, Octavia, that really got me because I know how carnal we are. But I know how God is, and he is faithful to his word. And y'all been coming here long enough to know I don't play with him at all. So when he asked, tell me these kind of things, I have to question him, you know. I said, God, you got to understand, you're dealing with people here. Some people got some, God help me here, including the pastor. You tell me something like this, I might go off my deep out there. He said, Charles, tell them that I'm giving you access to the things that you have desired.
Thank you, God.
I know that's kind of hard because that stuff in your mind, you can't see God give it to you. But if you just believe him and you don't know what he's going to do with it, then he give it to you. He said, you desire it. I'm giving you access to it. I'm going to give you the steps out to get this. You don't believe this. You don't have enough faith for this. The thing that you desire, the house you desire, the relationship you desire, the job you desire, the clothes you desire, y'all better don't bother me. You look like it can't happen. Look like the one I can't give it to you. But you know, but you desire it. God said, tell them I am going to give them the desires of their heart. Those things you secretly desire, that you're afraid to tell people because they think you're not qualified for it. So you can't tell them what you believe in God for. God said, well, now your secrets are made public. When I give you the stuff, you praying me right in their face. I'm going to take the sidebar right now because the Lord just dropped something in my spirit for five people. God says, I'm getting ready to prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies, the people who try to kill you. I'm going to raise you up right in front of them. I'm going to bless you right in their face. No matter what they're trying to do, I'm going to bless you right. They can't do nothing about it. That's the sidebar. Someone said, do it, Lord. Shut the hole. So he said, even the desires. Your secret desires, I've given you access. So God, want me to tell you this morning? I'll be done in 10 minutes because it's Father's Day. They take me out to dinner. Somebody say amen. I'm ordering the most expensive thing on the menu. Y'all remember my list. I don't care what it is. I don't really like it. I'm ordering the most expensive thing. Lord, God help me. So. He said, Charles, am I happy to you yet? He said, Charles, I'm giving you access. I want you to get this to me, this message. He said, I'm getting ready. I have now granted you access.
Thank you.
This is not nothing I'm giving you. This is something I've already given you. He said, I've now granted you access to the people. The people that you need to take your life to the next level. God said you have access to them right now. If you open your eyes and see, and get away from around them chicken, and know that you're an eagle, and start looking for other eagles, get around away from around them complainers, and then lack of faith people, and connect yourself to the people who are trying to go somewhere. God said, give you access to these people. Open your eyes and see them in the name of Jesus. You don't have to be light. You don't have to be popular. Time up for being broken, disgusted, and frustrated. Yeah, lift up your head and look up, bro. I'm on the preacher a little bit longer than I want. Give me 5 minutes. Black time, 5 minutes black time. He says, I'm giving you access to the people. I'm going to stay right here. Because when God gives you access to people, for your destiny, they gonna make you uncomfortable.
Yes!
I think I was telling Pastor Pender on the phone yesterday. It might have been my wife I was talking to. I said, listen, when I go with these pastors I'm hanging with now, I don't feel good.
But
the stuff they've accomplished and the things they're doing.
it.
It's a challenge. They're stretching me, Q. They make me look at myself. I say, y'all want to stay here? Or they want to move on to where they are? God will never say that. You're going to be uncomfortable for the people downstairs in your life to stretch you. They're not going to be like you. They're not going to be doing what you were doing. They're not going to be like the people you've been hanging around. They can be people with destiny, a vision, a purpose. God, help me to preach this. But you got to learn them when you see them. You're I'm talking to someone. Look at them. They put your pride aside. Get your butt out of the way. Ain't no buts about this. God says I'm connecting some people. Grab all these people when they come. Yes, it's uncomfortable. Yes, you see the left hand. Grab all them when they come. I receive this song. Hallelujah. You think about groups of people. You don't know how I feel about that. Groups of people keep you stuck.